Chickity check, chickity check. Welcome in, Pirate fans. You're here live for tonight's broadcast of Wheelersburg football. I am your host, the Duke of Earl. And there goes Coach Caskey up to his roost to get ready to call the offense tonight as Wheelersburg is hosting West here on senior night at Ed Miller Stadium in the Burg. Thanks to Nervous Rex Up All Night Barbecue for feeding BurgFan.com before the game. If you were out and about, you probably ran into the Duke and Nervous Rex out on the street slinging some barbecue. Had a few people stop by, and hopefully that's something we'll continue to do for home games coming up. Just to add a little bit of atmosphere to the community, game day atmosphere to the community. On game day, we had a good time, and thanks to those who stopped by and joined us. About 4.5 minutes to go into a kickoff here. Band is out on the field, as well as the seniors and the parents who are forming a tunnel and waiting for the Burg to make their arrival here tonight. Very light crowd tonight. This game is not a typical, the buildup is not there that you would typically see for a Burg West game. Typically, the SOC would be on the line in a game with Burg versus West in Week 10, the Halloween Bowl. But this year, West has not won an SOC game yet coming into this game. They have not won a game. So they've lost to Valley. They've lost to Oak Hill, Memphard, Waverly. And after tonight, they will have lost to the Burg if the Pirates can come out and execute, play clean football, protect the ball, take care of each other's jobs, know your role, shut your mouth and play ball. Get the job done. Here comes the Burg tonight in all orange. Orange pants, orange tops, orange hats, looking nice. Looking real nice. I'll get a shot here for you and post it on the Facebook page, so you can see the Burg in all orange. They're getting their swag on in the end zone. I'll share that up for you here on BurgFan.com's Facebook page. If you're just tuning in, thank you. Wheelersburg with 3 losses on the season. Coming into the game 6-3. They are the front runner for the SOC, and a win tonight will secure them the outright SOC championship. Already guaranteed a share of it. All they got to do is come in, punch the clock, go to work, execute, and clock in another SOC. So the maintenance crew preparing another spot in the trophy case for Wheelersburg right now. There you go. If you're on the Facebook page, you can check that out now. A little Pirate swag. Coming out before the game. You'll see how it goes. We've got the shout-out line open, 740-357-8085. Thanks again for tuning in. We do have a shout-out already. The Burg is playing the team from East Friendship. That is correct. They are from the east side of Friendship. So if you're heading west on 52, you will run into East Friendship before you run into Friendship. And you'll probably keep driving a long way before you actually find Friendship as we know it. So here comes the west side. They'll be in black pants tonight, white tops, and white hats. Again, the Pirates in their all-orange uniforms. Metallic orange, looking very nice. Referees in their very trendy vertically striped zebra tops with the black pants. Eddie Deemer is back tonight in the press box doing the PA announcements. Glad to have him back. Jason Smith is out with an injury. It's yet to be determined if he will return for the playoffs, but we do hope him. Hope he has a speedy recovery. And an injury walking down from the press box last week. Was unable to make it back up this week. So our best wishes to him. Hopefully he can get back up. All right, time to liven it up here at Ed Miller Stadium as the Blizz hands off the tee to number 80, Braxton Sammons, the Boomstick. Last check, Pirates came into this game favored 41.5 points. They were the favorite tonight. Pirate sideline is alive. They're jumping up and down. A sea of orange from the 35 to the 35. Nice, shiny orange helmets. Man, those things glow. But here we go with the Boomstick. Kicks it. And this first one is a squib kick. Bounces. Takes a high bounce. And will be fielded by the west side at the 31-yard line. That's where they'll take over first and 10. Other action tonight, we have Portsmouth at Ironton. Ironton expected to win that game, favored by more than 30 points. There will be some movement in the region tonight for Region 19 to determine who Wheelersburg will play. It looks like if they win tonight, they will certainly host in week 11, but it's to be determined who they will play based on a lot of other matchups tonight, and it's really close, so it's really hard to speculate on who that might be, although I'm calling Wellston right now. So here comes the west side offense, single back formation. Quarterback looks to throw on first down, and he's got his man wide open down the field. It's caught in Wheelersburg territory down at the 38-yard line. Nobody in coverage there, so a great play design on first down by Wheelersburg. It's something they must have caught on film right there and tried it right out of the gate, and it worked. The pass was a little bit behind the receiver. If he had led his receiver there, he's got a touchdown because there was nobody around, but the receiver did have to wait on the pass, allowing Micaiah Matthews, the free safety, to come across the field and make the stop. Single back formation again, man in motion. And they hand off to the man in motion on a jet sweep. And he picks up a nice little gain of about 4 yards. He'll bring up second down and six. So Pirate defense being tested here early in the game.
Stop made by number 52, Caleb Johnson.
As you heard Eddie Deemer in the background there, number 52, Caleb Johnson, was the tackler. West side breaks their huddle, single back with an H-back. Looking to throw again. Over the middle, and it's a nice pass deflected. And a great play by Ruby. Ruby coming across in front of the receiver with his opposite hand and making a textbook defensive back play. Very nice job there by Ruby Rue. Ruby Rue had an injury earlier in the season, but he has come back strong, and he is definitely one of the top playmakers on this team. Single back set again for West Side, number 9 in motion. This is a handoff to the running back, and gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about it as the Pirate defense stiffens up there, and this will bring up fourth down and 5 for the so-called Senators.
Caleb Johnson and number 53, Brady Warner. It'll bring up fourth down and 5 for the Senators. Ball spot on the Pirates, 31-yard line.
10:20 to go. Ball at the 31-yard line. It's fourth down and 5 for the Senators. No score on the board. Pirate defense is in a 5-2 set. Quarterback rolling out. He's got a man wide open. But the Pirate defense collapses on the pocket and brings down the quarterback for a sack, a loss of 7 on the play, and it'll be a turnover on downs. Pirates take over, first and 10, and we'll wait to see where the ball is spotted. They'll mark that at the 39-yard line, and here comes the General E. Horse Lee out to command his troops. L.J. Payton breaks the huddle and goes wide to the left. That's Adam Vastine wide to the right. Ruby in the slot, and Hedgehog the single back. The general under center hands it off. No, keeps it on a midline option. And we have an inadvertent whistle as they thought Micaiah Matthews had the ball. They blew the play dead after a two-yard gain as the play continued outside. Horsley was tackled also for a two-yard gain, so they got both of them right. But a new look here for this Pirate offense, coming right out and going under center and running traditional option with the Hedgehog.
Run by number six, Evan Horsley.
So inadvertent whistle didn't hurt anything there. Or did it? I believe they're going to go play over.
There was an inadvertent whistle. We will replay the down.
Yep, that's what they're going to do. So they're going to admit they had an inadvertent whistle, and they're going to replay the down. So when the whistle blew, everybody did stop, with the exception of the two players on the outside here, with Horsley being one and the other being his tackler. So Pirates break huddle, and we'll go first and 10 once again. This time Horsley in the gun with the Hedgehog alongside him. Here comes Ruby in motion. Horsley looks to throw, gets it out to Micaiah Matthews, and he may be gone. There he goes. Touchdown, Micaiah Matthews. No contest there at all. Just a swing pass out to Micaiah Matthews. A couple guys in coverage. And in the open field, you're just not going to bring him down. It's not going to happen. College is out there looking for a running back that can work in the open field and can make big plays in the open field. You got to give Micaiah Matthews a hard look. That's talent. That's raw talent. Not everybody's got it. And he's certainly doing a lot with it here at Wheelersburg, as the Pirates take the lead 7-0 with 9:37 to go in the first quarter. We'll be back on BurgFan.com.
Why is that?
Party people! Yeah! Tag team music in full effect. That's me, DC, the Brain Supreme, and my man Steve Rowland. We're kicking the flow.
We're kicking the flow.
And it goes a little something like this. Tag team back.
Back at the Ed as Ozzy Osbourne makes his appearance on the sound system, with the Pirates holding that 7-0 lead here early in the game. Had some score predictions tonight. All of them were around the 50-7 mark. Dylan picked 52-0 as the final. Let's see what Buzz has got going on here. Shout out from Point Pleasant, Aunt Terry. So, Aunt Terry, thanks for tuning in. And here's a little chip kick. Looked like a pitching wedge as it went out to the 37-yard line, where it'll be downed by West. And they'll take over first and 10. Shout out to Holy Crap, you can understand the PA guy. Thank you for tuning in from Point Pleasant. Say hi to the Mothman. And let's see. Here we go with the Buzz prediction. 49-7. 49-7 is what the Buzz has. So Buzz 49-7 and Dylan 52-0. I formation this time for West. Quarterback turns, hands off to the right side. Running back will be brought down for a loss of two on the play as the clock runs now under 9.5 minutes in the first quarter.
Sound made by number 53, Brady Warner. It'll be second down and 12 for
the D. Malk in the house.
35-yard line.
He's using a new type of shampoo. Single back formation for West Portsmouth. Out of the gun, quarterback looking to throw, dances around in the pocket, completes a pass right to the line of scrimmage. Receiver had to go down to a knee to make the catch, so he's down right where he catches it.
It'll bring up third down and long.
Actually be a loss of one on the play, so bring up third and 13 for the Senators. Shout out to all the folks out listening that are traveling around playing Travel League softball. Good luck this weekend. Go represent. Make a name for yourself. Put some runs across the plate. Single back formation for West on third and 13. Pirates bring in all kinds of pressure, and he's sacked for a big loss. A loss of 11 on the play. And that was the entire defensive line. I believe that was Eli Swords in there leading the way, number 23. He was coming hard off the edge on that play. Several guys got there at the same time. Don't know if he can have a three-way sack or not. So the Siders will punt on fourth and 25. Here's the kick. It's an end-under-end kick, and Hedgehog will field it. No fair catches, he says, and he's tackled immediately. Great job fielding it. Was not able to get away from the defender and was brought down immediately. No gain on the return. Ball will be spotted first and 10 at the 48, so great field position for your Pirates. And here comes Horsley out. Still has that limp, still gimpy. Bring out the gimp, they say. And he calls the play and breaks the huddle. L.J. Payton goes wide to the left, trips out there to the left side this time. Single receiver to the right. And we have encroachment on the defense as man in motion. Man started in motion, and that drew the Senators offsides. So it'll be a 5-yard penalty on the defense. And high school ball, once you cross the line and you're in the neutral zone, it's blown dead immediately. You don't get the opportunity to get back. So, again, trips to the left. And Micaiah Matthews in motion. Here's a quick throw out to Ruby. Makes a catch on an out route, a 7-yard gain, and a first down for the Pirates. Nice timing route on the out route there. Good throw by the general, Horsley.
Number 23, Ryan Sissel. It'll be first down and 10 for the Pirates. Ball spot at the Senator 39-yard line.
So it'll be Swords in there in the backfield this time as Micaiah Matthews moves out to the slot, and they bring him in motion. They'll do a jet sweep counter here to Micaiah Matthews. He'll cut it back up the middle. Nice play design there, throwing a little wrinkle into that Pirate offense. And it's a gain of 11 on the play and a first down. Play looked like the sweep that they typically run to Micaiah Matthews or Ruby. But the blocking was designed a little different for a cutback. It worked pretty well. Here comes Ruby now in motion, and he will get it on the sweep. And he's got the corner. And he's brought down at about the 6-yard line. A gain of 20 on the play for another Pirate first down. West Side has nothing for this Pirate offense. Nothing at all. No energy. Pretty quiet here at the end tonight. It's kind of like a library.
6-yard line.
If you're just tuning in, Pirates are leading 7-0 with 6:20 to go in the first quarter, and the Pirates have it first and goal at the 6. Be Swords in the backfield, Matthews in motion, and General looking to throw, overthrows his target. Incomplete, so it'll bring up now second and goal.
It'll bring up second down and goal for the Pirates.
That was intended for Bastine. Out to the right, number 10. Pirates moving from left to right. In the all orange tonight. Orange pants, orange shirts, orange hats. Here's Horsley off the quarterback keep. Pushes his way up and into the end zone for a touchdown. Wheelersburg. And so Horsley makes it now 13-0, and here comes Braxton Sammons, the boomstick, the hero of the overtime game with Ashland, to put it up and through for the extra point to make it 14-0 with 6 minutes and 1 second to go. We'll be back. Well, it's a tidbit nipply out here tonight in the Burg. I believe it's under 40 degrees or close to that. It feels about that. So here comes the boomstick to kick it off. This time he will kick it directly into the ground and watch it bounce. Fielded by West at about the 23-yard line. Nice athlete there for West. Number 13 scoops it up and makes a couple whoop-de-doo moves. Finally brought down at the 35-yard line, and that's where the West Siders will take over, wearing their black pants, white jerseys, and white helmets.
It'll be first down and 10 for the Senators. Ball spot on their own 35-yard line.
So Senators go under center. It'll be slot eye to the right, unbalanced line. And handoff inside to the fullback on a trap play. Picks up a couple yards as he just falls forward. Brought down by Miller.
Run by number 35.
As well as Warner.
It'll be second down and 8 for the Senators. Ball spot on their own 37-yard line.
Hot chocolate would be good tonight. It's a good night for hot chocolate. Maybe that's what we'll do next weekend, Rex. We'll just serve hot chocolate in your front yard. So here comes the man in motion for West Side, single back, and handed off on a counter, number 13 again. Nice carry, nice shifty moves, and is wrapped up after a gain of 3. So it'll bring up 3rd down and 5.
From number 13, William Journey. Stop by number 20,
for the Friendship
Atkins.
Senators.
To bring up 3rd down and 5 for the Senators. Ball spot on their own 40-yard line.
All right, so the band will be, I guess, singing tonight. Not sure about what's going on there. I just heard somebody say from now on we're singing. Here's a tall sweep for the side. Number 13 again with a nice carry, but it's not going to be enough for a first down. It's a gain of about 3 by Journey, and so be 4th and about 2. Bastine on the stop.
It'll bring up 4th down and 2 for the Senators. Ball spot of their own 43.
Looks like we might have a different band director tonight. I don't know if it's a new director or an assistant or if we're just changing things up. Definitely looks like a different person. Trips to the right this time for the side. Quarterback in pistol formation. He's going to throw it. Throws it quickly, and it is a nice catch. Tipped pass by number 9. Tips it down to himself and catches it on a 4th and 5. Or a 4th and 2, excuse me, and makes a first down.
Ball spot at the Pirates' 48-yard line.
Ball will be spotted at the 48-yard line of Wheelersburg. Second time tonight the Senators have been in Wheelersburg territory. Nothing on the scoreboard to show for it, though, as it remains 14-0 with 3:15 to go in the first quarter. Shout out to our Burg fans in San Diego tuning in tonight. We appreciate you, the loyal listeners there. And we've got a handoff cut back by the running back, Journey, and picks up two on the play. So it'll be second and eight, William Journey.
Stop made by number 52.
This is the running back, number 13, and he comes up limping. As he's been active early in the game quite a bit, but he is struggling to get off to the sideline. And he takes his helmet off in disgust, and they're going to look at him immediately and send in a backup. So here we go, single back formation for the Senators. Quarterback drops back to throw. He's under heavy pressure, and it's a low pass and almost picked off the turf by Swords, but he's unable to scoop it up, so it'll bring up third down and nine. Caught third and eight for the Senator Siders. L.J. Payton playing the right cornerback position. That's Bastine. He plays the strong safety. And there is Micaiah Matthews, the free safety, and Ruby, the left corner. Quick screen pass out to the left side, and it's knocked down by Bastine. No, excuse me, that is Gage Adkins there, number 20, coming off the edge, gets his hands up and knocks that pass down. So now it'll be fourth and eight. And here comes the punt team for the side. If you're not a regular listener, don't know the opponents in the area, they are the West Portsmouth Senators, also known as the West Siders or Portsmouth West. Lots of other things. So I'll refer to them as several different things, like East Manchester.
First down and 10 for the Pirates. Ball spotted at their own 24-yard line.
I think I'm going to set an alarm on my phone to wake me up in about 45 minutes. All right, here comes the Pirate offense, and here comes Horsley. Brings his man in motion. That is Maxey, and the throw is out to Maxey, and it's high. But Maxey's like 8 feet tall, so he goes up and gets it, catches it, has a gain of six, and that'll bring up second down and four.
It'll be second down and four for the Pirates. Ball spot on their own 30-yard line.
Maxey, a very talented player, trying to find different ways to get him involved in the offense. Now they split him out wide to the left, trying to draw some attention out there. Here's the handoff inside, and a nice explosion up through the hole. Then a gain of six and a first down for Wheelersburg. That was Swords on the carry. And I tell you what, when Swords gets the ball, he's just a sophomore. But when he gets the ball, he explodes through the hole.
And number 23, Ryan
Sissel. A little bit old school in that approach. Doesn't really try to pick his spot. But when he sees his spot, he explodes through it. And he's done a great job this season. Trips to the left this time for the Burg. It's going to be a throw for Horsley. He's under pressure but escapes the pocket to his left. And he's got somebody all by himself. And it's going to be a touchdown, Wheelersburg. And that's Gage Adkins. There wasn't a defender in the same zip code. There wasn't anybody around that could even share an electoral vote with him. I mean, nobody in coverage. Nobody. So it makes it 20-0 now here in the first quarter. So here comes the boomstick to add on an extra point to make it 21-0. And the kick is up and good. With 52.3 to go in the first quarter, the Pirates lead 21-0. Thanks for tuning in on BurgFan.com.
Woo! Y'all know who I am, right?
Love that on that beat.
Let's go!
No masterpiece. Hey. 10 bad babs and they after me.
Bam.
One bad bad look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford them.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford them.
Big,
give me the beat, I ride it like a jet ski.
Hey.
So many bad bad, they harassing me.
Bad.
They like me cause I rap and be with the athletes. Stop asking me, I know they mad at me.
Nah.
Hop in the coupe, then I slide like it's Vaseline. West Coast 6-4, jump like a trampoline. Take a brick out, put it on the triple beam.
Brick
I'm not from Canada, but I see a lot of teams.
Canada.
Dismantle her, I know how to handle her. Light the candle up, make you put a banner up. Toss a 50 up, make them tie the club
up.
Took your bitch out the game, I had to sub her.
Swap.
No masterpiece.
Hey.
10 bad babs and they after me.
Bam.
One bad bad look like a masterpiece.
One bad bad. One bad bad look like a masterpiece. Here comes the boomstick. Again, Squibb kicks it to the left, and the up man flags it down and tags it down at the 43-yard line, and that's where the Senator Siders will take over first and 10.
First down and 10 for the Senators. Ball's on their own 43-yard line.
Clock operator was quick on that one. Exactly 0.2 seconds came off the clock. It's got nice fast twitch muscle reflexes. All right, West Portsmouth this time comes out with that same set, single back, quarterback in the pistol. They'll move the H back across the formation, and here's the handoff to Journey. He's run down from behind.
Number 13, William Journey.
And tackled hard, and he's going to stay down this time. Be second down and seven, but there's a timeout on the field for an injury. So he hobbled off the last time he was out there. And this time kind of brought down, I don't know if you want to say awkwardly, but brought down from behind where you're not expecting to be hit. And he'll be helped off the field. And here comes the substitute for the Siders. Clock will start back up with 40 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Senators have one nice pass completion here in the game. Two first downs so far. This time trips to the left, and the quarterback's going to roll to his left, looking out in the flats, and this one's picked off by Gage Atkins, number 20. Can he push it into the end zone and get two? He does. Atkins with back-to-back touchdown. Make it 27-0 here in the first quarter. Gage Atkins. Catches a nice 60-yard pass, turns around on the next series, and picks off a west side pass and takes it to the house for the six. So Braxton Salmon's getting a lot of action tonight, number 80, the kicker. He has kicked off four times already, and now he will be kicking his fourth extra point. There's the kick. It's up and good. So with 8.8 to go in the first quarter, it's now 28-0 Wheelersburg. And you will be tuning out early tonight. And thank you for tuning in as always. be sticking around tonight to give you the first half action, and then we're out of here. I've had a long day today at BurgFan.com, grilling out with Up All Night Barbecue, down on Old Gallia Pike, feeding the fans, feeding the millions and millions of Burg fans. All right, here comes the boomstick. And this one, he just kind of pooch kicks it, and it goes all the way to the west side 15 where it's fumbled. And the returner is absolutely lit up. That was Micaiah Matthews. The returner Anderson wished he did not pick that ball up because he got trucked. Absolutely trucked, and Matthews is fired up. He loves it, and his teammates love it. Putting on a show tonight, and they're asking for the fans to get on their feet. I want to hear some noise. Pirates are having fun playing football. .425 set for the Pirates now. Quarterback in the pocket. Tries to escape but cannot. And he is sacked. Luke Miller brings down the quarterback for another Pirate sack, a loss of five. And that'll be the end of the first quarter. Pirates lead 28-0. I'll be back. Thanks for tuning in.
10 bad, bad, then they after me. One bad, bad, like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip, big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford it.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford it.
Pick the name. Make her open up and eat it. Stars in the ceiling in my seats, they Tempur-Pedic. I see them up with watching and they plotting, trying to sneak me. I can't hear the thought, can't trust the thought, they telling secrets. Big back, take, look back, little nuke. Catch them down bad and looking, cry a whole river. Long for my back, I'm taking care of the whole village. Somebody got shot, what you talking about, Willis? In the lobby with a brick of wicked Bobby with your dip. I go Lawrence with the fit, in the Rory with no tent. I'm from the trench, I got the dirty money rent. He was popping, so I popped and pray to God repent.
No masterpiece. Ten bad bad, then they after me. One bad bad, look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford them.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't.
Back here for the start of the second quarter. Pirates leading 28-0. Checking the shout-out line now. Thanks for shouting me out. Handoff up the middle. No gain on the play. Brings up third down and 14 for the Pirates. Can get the ScoreStream app. Usually Adam Payton is on there keeping that updated. ScoreStream will give you local scores from many games. And those are user-driven. So somebody at the game actually keeping score there. Try the ScoreStream app. And we will also post score updates on our Facebook page as the night progresses. And here is a completed pass out to the running back in the flats for the Siders, and a gain of about 10 on the play. Gets the ball out near the marker, and that'll be a first down.
Stop made by number 58, Jackson Coons. It'll be first down and 10 for the Senators. Ball spotted their own 32-yard line.
Some rotations now coming in for the Pirate defense. Senators break huddle, but don't look like they're too confident in the play calls. You see a lot of guys grabbing the wristbands there to take a second look. And it's just a handoff inside that goes for – that ends up getting bounced to the outside, to the left side for Journey, and he picks up about one on the play. It'll bring up second down and 9 for the Senators. Slot formation to the right this time for the Tigers. Quarterback looking to throw a quick out route, and it is complete in the flats for a short gain, a gain of about 4 yards, we'll say, and it brings up third down and 4. Bastein was there on the stop.
It'll be third down and 4 for the Senators. Ball spot on their own 34-yard line.
Ball's at the 38-yard line of Wheelersburg. 9:25 to go in the second quarter. Pirates leading 28-0. Senators with the ball, third and 4. Quarterback looking to throw, now shimmies to his left, throws it up and out of bounds. And that'll bring up fourth and 4.
Mitchell Irwin's pass is incomplete.
And the Siders will have to punt it away. Hedgehog, who had rotated out on defense, Makai Matthews will now check back in here for punt return as he goes back deep to field it. He's just waiting on somebody to kick one to him. We'll see if they will give him a shot at one here. Here's the snap. Snap's good. The kick is going to not go to the Hedgehog, but he's going to scoop it up anyway. He chases it down and scoops it up. He wants a return so bad that nobody will let him play. He's willing to forego all fair catches just to have a chance to return one.
It'll be first down and 10 for the Pirates.
So ball will be at the 35-yard line. That's where the Pirates will take over first and 10 and bring out the gimp. Here comes Evan E. Horsley. He's got a bad leg, got a bad wheel. What are you going to do? It's your senior year. Yeah, he could take some time off and heal, but he wants to play. Man wants to play ball. That's what he's doing. Here he goes, and he will throw it out quickly. And a nice catch there by Bastein. Who fumbles, and it is picked up by the Senators.
Fumble recovery by number 60, Joe Igans.
So the Siders will take over first and 10 ball at the 39-yard line of Wheelersburg. They have good field position now. Down by 28 points with 8:51 to go in the second quarter. Slot right formation this time for the Senators. Single back. Man in motion across. Handoff off tackle to the right. Running back breaks through the first line of defense. Picks up 4 on the play. Bring up second down and 6.
It'll be second down and 7 for the Senators. Ball spot on the Pirates, 36-yard line.
Again, it's senior night here in the Burg. The crowd is very, 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 very light tonight. Not expected to be a competitive game, and it hasn't been. It's 28-0. Here is the handoff to the fullback left side. He runs with some power, runs over a Wheelersburg tackler, picks up a couple yards, and makes it third down and about 4.
Made by number 53, Brady Warner. down and four for the Senators. Ball spot on the Pirates' 34-yard line.
Same formation, single back, man in motion for the side. Draw play. Running back breaks it off to the right side, but he will be tackled short by about a yard. And it'll bring up fourth and one, and I believe West Side will go for it here on fourth and one. Pirates will bring out Man Bear Pig, bring him into the play. So here comes the short yardage package for the Pirates. Man Bear Pig in there. And a little guy comes out. Big man in, little guy out.
It'll be a fourth down and one for the Senators. Ball spot on the Pirates, 30 yards.
So a big fourth and one here for the Pirate defense. West Side will tighten it up this time. No splits, and it's a quarterback sneak. It looks like he got enough progress. It's going to depend on the spot, really. It's close. Looked like he may have leaned into it enough to get the chains to move. But they're probably going to have to measure it. There's the spot. Official had a good eye on it. First down.
It'll be a Senator first down.
All they needed was one. That's all they got. Clock running now at 6 minutes and 30 seconds in the second quarter. Pirates leading 28-0. Ball at the 29-yard line, first and 10 for the Senators. Man in motion across the formation. They will give it to that man. Gets a nice block on the edge, cuts it back up inside. Ball pops out, and I believe Wheelersburg recovers it. They did, but the official's going to come in and say the runner was down. The runner down after a gain of, we'll say, six. Denny on the stop.
It'll be second down and four for the Senators.
Looked like a fumble. The Pirates believed it was a fumble. The referee says no, the runner was down. So that's what we'll go with. Man in motion across the formation. Off tackle to the runner, number 35 there. Big, hefty boy. Runs it for a gain of three. And we'll make it third and one for the Senators. They're content with 3 yards and a cloud of dust so far.
Stop made by number 22, Luke Miller. It'll bring up third down and one for the Senators. Ball spot the Pirates' 20-yard line.
It's the West Side Band now starts to gather in the south end zone, getting ready for their halftime performance. And here comes the man in motion across the formation. Handoff again, 35. This time slams it up in the middle there. And he's close to the first down marker. Might be short. Referee signaling fourth down. So it will be fourth and one again for the Senators. And they will go for it again.
It'll bring up fourth down and inches for the Senators.
So second time on this drive, it's fourth and short. They literally are getting 3 yards in a cloud of dust right now. No more than that. I formation again. Quarterback fumbles at this time, and there are penalty flags before the snap. Dead ball, false start on the offense. So this is going to make it now a fourth and six for the offense. That may have saved the West Side there because the ball was fumbled on the snap. And the quarterback had to go to his knees to scoop it up. Definitely would not have made enough progress to get the first down. So they'll get another shot at it, but it's going to be fourth and six instead of fourth and inches. Slot right formation. And here's going to be the pass out into the left side flats. Vastine there in coverage. And it'll be incomplete. Excuse me, Ruby in there on coverage. And it's incomplete. Turnover on downs. Wheelersburg takes over first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Here comes the General Horsley. Try to lead these Pirates to a running clock type of score. OHSAA rule says if you're ahead by more than 30 points in the second half, then we're going to run the clock nonstop, with the exception of timeouts, injuries, and the end of the quarter. Here comes Horsley with the snap. Hands it off. That is...
run by Case Dyer.
Dyer on the carry, number 13, tackled immediately. A loss of two on the play. So L.J. Payton will come out here wide to the left. That'll be Vastine wide to the right.
Tackled by Blake Partlow. It'll bring up second down and 11.
Dyer will be in the backfield with Horsley, and that'll be Micaiah Matthews in the slot on the right-hand side. Pirates moving from right to left, headed towards the north end zone. Horsley calls for the Hedgehog in motion. He's dropping back to throw. He runs out of time but finds a receiver open on a shovel pass. It's complete. A gain of two on the play.
Catch by Lane Charles.
It was Lane Charles on the catch for the Pirates.
Stop made by Luke Bradford. Gonna bring up third down and 10 for the Pirates. Ball spot of their own 25-yard line.
So 2:45 to go here in the first half. On third and 10 for the Pirates. Here comes the man in motion. They'll fake it to him. Looking to throw to him now, and they do. And it's going to be a lateral that will be covered up. Now they're going to rule it an incomplete pass.
The pass will be incomplete.
Goes through the Hedgehog's hands.
It'll bring up fourth down.
The general forced that one in there. They were trying to throw that out on a swing pass after they faked it to him. It just wasn't open, but Horsley went ahead and tried to execute the play. The Hedgehog could not make the catch, probably for the better. So the Pirates will punt. I'm good.
Morning.
And Shaw there offering me a table. I could have grabbed one. I didn't need one tonight. I'm solo. So I'm nice and comfy here. Get a sit up closer to the fence when there's not a table here. It's nice. Makes it easier to see both ends of the field. We've got a timeout on the field. But for some reason, the clock's running still.
She's always got candy. Trick or treat.
Not really sure why, but it is. Down to 30 seconds. So clock running here during the timeout. Just kind of awkward and neat. Eugene not paying any attention. Clock's now under 5 seconds. Nobody's watching this at all. And they finally catch it. Flag comes out before the snap. And we'll call delay of game on Wheelersburg.
Delay of game against the Pirates.
I think what happened there was on the timeout, the clock operator switched it to a 60-second clock to count down the timeout. And what happened was the official used that clock to call the delay of game when he shouldn't have. So here's the kick. Boomstick with a nice spiral kick. This one will be impossible to field, and it'll roll out of bounds in the West Side territory. And wait on the official here. The Zebra marks it at the 48-yard line.
The Pirates' kick will go out of the 48-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for the Senators.
So Senators with 2:23 to go here in the first half take over at their own 48. Anybody listening wants to text me any scores from around the area currently, that would be appreciated. I'll get those announced. Waverly 13, Oak Hill 7 right now.
Run by Luke Bradford. Stop made by Seth Denny.
7 minutes left in the first half. Ironton 13, Portsmouth 0. I'd like to see Portsmouth do well in that game. So far not getting blown out, but that could change at any moment. Drop back pass here for Westside, and this one is going to be jumped and almost picked off. Nice job jumping the route.
Pass broken up by number 10, Adam Vastine.
That was Vastine. He exploded when the receiver broke on his route. Quarterback released the pass. Vastine exploded off his back foot. Made a great play to get in front of the receiver and had it picked. But the receiver got his hand up in there to help knock it down. Drop back pass again. Quarterback runs out of time, and he's brought down hard on the play. A sack on the play, and a timeout for Wheelersburg. As I believe that was Jackson Coons, number 58, in there on the sack. Timeout Wheelersburg as they'll try to preserve some time here remaining in the first half. Up by 28 points, they want to try to push that to 30 or more and get to that mercy rule situation. Then they can bring out some reserves for the second half. So it looks like the Pirates will move on to the postseason. They'll be hosting a game here at Ed Miller Stadium next week. I believe this year's playoff games are on Saturday, so stay tuned for that. We'll keep you updated. We'll let you know who we're going to be playing. Right now it looks like it could be any number of teams, Wellston being one of those teams, Columbus Academy being one of those teams, Portsmouth being one of those teams, Memphis being one of those teams. There's some various things that can happen tonight to change and to determine who will travel to Wheelersburg next week and play.
The Senators kick will be down at the 29-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for the Pirates.
And it'll be down at the 29-yard line. That's where the Pirates will take over first and 10 after the punt. So Pirates with 1:32 to go here in the half. They have one timeout. They'll try to get a drive put together here, work a little two-minute drill action. And bring out the gimp. Here comes General E. Horse Lee limping out to the huddle. Been limping all season. Hasn't slowed him down a bit. Maybe it has a bit, but it hasn't stopped him. Empty backfield this time, but he brings a man in motion, and that's Matthews, who he hands it off to. Matthews explodes and is hit hard in open field, fumbles. The ball comes out. He spun around, and he falls on his own fumble and recovers it.
By number 23, Ryan Sissel. It'll be first down and 10 for the Pirates. Ball spot.
No harm, no foul there. Gain of 31 on the play by Micaiah Matthews. Ball spotted at the 40-yard line of West. Hedgehog in motion the other way, and they will give it to him again. This time it's a double reverse. And Ruby gets it on the double reverse. Makes a defender. Stiff arms. And is run out of bounds after a gain of 11.
It'll be first down and 10 for the Pirates. Ball spotted at the Senator 29-yard line.
Swords checks out, and that'll be L.J. Payton checking in. Ruby stays on the field. And here comes Gage Atkins to check in at that tight end spot. He'll line up as his tight end on the right side. L.J. Payton now in the slot. Bastine wide to the right. Hedgehog wide to the left. They're looking for the quick throw, and they get it to L.J. Payton. And he explodes after the catch. Picks up eight on the play. Clock will continue running. He tried to get out of bounds there wisely. But clock now at 45 seconds. Pirates have time on second down and two. Plenty of time. They will spike it here to stop the clock with 40.1 seconds to go. A great opportunity here to work on two-minute drill. L.J. Payton now breaks huddle, comes wide to the left. That'll be Gage Atkins in the slot. Two by two this time for the Pirates. Ruby motions to make it trips, and here goes Ruby up over the top, and oh, what a beautiful lob pass by Horsley.
By number nine, Luke Bradford.
He put that up and landed it right in the bucket, but Ruby was not able to come up with it. I believe the defender got a hand in there. But that's just one of those throws where you know where your receiver is going to be and you're throwing it up there. He's not even looking for the pass yet. You just throw it knowing he's going to get there, and he got there. Unable to complete it. So it's fourth and two with 33.9. Pirates will go for it. They call for the man in motion. Give it to the Hedgehog, and touchdown, Willisburg. Number 29, Micaiah Matthews, makes it 34-0. So Pirates send a man in motion across the formation. That kind of pulls the defensive end out. And then they hand it off to Matthews up the middle. And there was two defenders there that maybe got a hand on Matthews, but he's so explosive. If he gets to run directly through the line of scrimmage, there's no way you can get a good angle to tackle him well. Boomstick puts it up and through. It's good, 35-0 in the first half. Pirates, total domination. Back here as the Pirates climb to a 35-0 lead. Still in the first half. Braxton Sammons, the boomstick, will come out to tee it up. He will stand it up right on the X on the field, which is at the 40-yard line, right in the middle of the field. Not the center, but the middle. So here we go. The boomstick will pooch it this time into no man's land, and it's scooped up by a returner and immediately tackled. What a play. Ian Fannin off the corner rips down the would-be returner.
Kick return by Brandon Anderson.
The big stick. Man, when he gets an opportunity to make a hit, he tattoos him, and he did there. Just an excellent, sure tackle.
It'll be first down and 10 for the Senators. Ball spot on their own 23-yard line.
Ian Fannin, number three. Great play. A senior out of Dogwood Ridge, Ohio. jet sweep this time to the left for the Senators. Ball comes out. And
there's a fumble on the play.
I believe it's recovered by Wheelersburg. It is.
Recovered by the Pirates.
So with 9.4 seconds to go, Wheelersburg will have a chance to put another score on the board. Luke Miller, number Deuce Deuce, 22, on the recovery. Double deuce. Horsley leads his troops out once again. The General E. Horsley. Micaiah Matthews lines up in the slot to the left. Maxey out wide to the left. And they're going to throw it. Maxey in the corner of the end zone. It's a jump ball. And the defender, nice job, gets a hand in there on it. As they just threw a 50-50 ball up to Maxey. Didn't get really good position
the
there.
The pass was broken up by Ashton Kleiber.
They took a shot at it, and now they'll give Braxton Sammons a shot at the field goal. So the ball will be placed down at the 29-yard line, making this a 39-yard kick. Got to work on these in game action. So good call here by the coaching staff. Take every point you can get. Here's the kick. Sammons with a driving, long, deep kick, and it's up and good. Nice job. So Sammons needed that. He's missed on a couple recently, and that'll help build his confidence up. So thank you all for tuning in tonight. Pirates lead going into halftime, 38-0. BurgFan.com.